To prepare for evacuations, some building owners equip their exit enclosures with backup lighting. But what happens when backup lighting fails or smoke reduces its effectiveness? When evacuees can't see where they're going, even the best evacuation plan can become a rush to the exit, where trampling, egress jams, and dangerous falls are the norm. To avoid these catastrophes, responsible building owners mark the perimeters of their exit enclosures with luminous striping according to the International Building Code and the International Fire Code. These codes apply to buildings that contain occupied floors above 75 feet from the lowest level of fire department vehicle access. When you apply demarcation lines, you'll begin by applying them to stair landings in 1 to 2 inch wide stripes that aren't separated by more than 4 inches. The lines can be wall-mounted or floor-mounted. After outlining perimeter landings, you'll also outline obstacles. Some common examples of obstacles are standpipes, hose cabinets, and restricted height areas. Finally, you'll apply lines to the frames and hardware of exit-leading doors. The tops and sides of door frames should be marked with a continuous 1 to 2 inch wide stripe. Door hardware should be marked with no less than 16 square inches of luminous striping, which should be placed behind, immediately adjacent to, or on the door handle. When doors have panic bars, a stripe no less than 1 inch should extend the length of the panic bar. When you apply demarcation lines to your building's exit enclosures, you'll invest a small amount of money, but in return, get a big payoff in safety. Luminous demarcation lines aren't a substitute for a well-rehearsed evacuation plan, but they do ensure that your evacuation plan will go smoothly if you ever have to use it.